en français.
Merci, bravo, bravo.
C'est vrai, British actress Helen Mirren parle français. But how good is it? What can we learn as French learners? Well, that's exactly what we're going to see in this video. Du coup, si vous êtes prêts, allez, c'est parti.
C'est la première fois que vous venez au festival pour le pur plaisir, sans avoir de film à défendre en tant
non,
que...
Non, pas la première fois. J'étais ici l'année passée avec L'Oréal encore. Et c'est vraiment, c'est bien parce qu'il n'y a pas de stress, vraiment. Quand il y a un film, il y a beaucoup de stress.
Now notice in that first clip how naturally she speaks French. I love her natural flow, her intonation. She sounds really at ease with the language. And in terms of things that she says, she uses both the full form of il y a, there is, there are, which I've mentioned a lot of times on the channel before, and she also uses the abbreviated form. So it shows you that both can be used. You go with the feeling, right? You go with the feeling, go with the flow. She says, il y a pas de stress, il y a pas de stress. And then she says, il y a beaucoup de stress. She's talking about two separate things, but il y a beaucoup de stress and il y a pas de stress.
C'est bien parce qu'il n'y a pas de stress, vraiment. Quand il y a un film, il y a beaucoup de stress.
Now she makes a mistake with gender of a word here. She says un film. Un film. And I know us French learners, we get really hung up on making mistakes with gender because we don't have that in English, right? And this is a recurring theme amongst all of the English speaking celebrities that I review speaking French. And I know this is something that gets a lot of us regular learners, if you like, non-celebrity learners, down while we're learning the language because it's really frustrating to make that sort of mistake. But what Helen shows us here in this video is that she can have a fluid interaction whilst making mistakes over gender. So that should tell us that our first goal should be communication and not to get too het up by mistakes over gender, because in the grand scheme of things, it's not so important. So thanks, Helen, for that lesson.
Dans la salle et tout ça.
Alors ici, she says something really natural in French again. She says, dans la salle et tout ça. Dans la salle et tout ça. And I want to focus on those last three words for a few seconds. Just et tout ça. Et tout ça. And all that. And everything like that. You don't need to say tout comme ça ou toutes les choses comme ça. All the things like that. It's just really natural to say et tout ça.
Alors comme ça, on peut s'amuser et porte les jolies robes, change la couleur des cheveux.
Alors, here we have a little bit of grammar to unpick. She says, on peut s'amuser, which is perfect. It's one can or we can have fun. So the grammar structure here is on peut, so it's the subject plus the conjugation and then any other verb after that. If it's in the same clause of the sentence, it has to be in the full form, the dictionary form. So just on peut s'amuser. You wouldn't say on peut s'amuse, for example. It's on peut s'amuser. Now the problem comes in the next part when she's continuing what she's saying. She's also saying other things that one can do. She then switches and uses a conjugation of the verb porter and changer. She says porte une jolie robe and change la couleur des cheveux. Now it should be porter une jolie robe et changer la couleur des cheveux, because it's flowing on from the on peut that she said in the first part. So yeah, any verb that follows the conjugated verb in a sentence, like here we have on peut plus three different verbs, they have to go in the dictionary form. So on peut s'amuser, on peut porter une jolie robe et on peut changer la couleur des cheveux.
C'est un rôle un petit peu pour vous?
C'est un peu un rôle. Vous avez absolument raison. C'est un peu un rôle.
I really love how she speaks the French language. It's probably on a similar level of quality of pronunciation as myself. She struggles ever so slight with the French R. She said, c'est un peu un rôle. C'est un peu un rôle. It could be a bit stronger. C'est un peu un rôle. If we listen to the host say the word rôle and then Helen say the word rôle, we can see and hear the difference.
C'est un rôle un petit peu pour vous?
C'est un peu un rôle. Vous avez absolument raison. C'est un peu un rôle.
And then she says, vous avez absolument raison. Vous avez absolument raison. Perfect pronunciation, at least to my English ears. And I pick this out because it's not obvious for us English speakers how to say you are right. We use to be in English, we say you are right. In French, just like with you are hot or you are cold, you have to use avoir, to have. So she says, vous avez absolument raison. Vous avez absolument raison. Technically, it's you have absolutely reason, but it means you are absolutely right. So another way you could say that is c'est ça, ou c'est tout à fait ça, ou c'est absolument ça, or you could even just simply say, je suis d'accord avec vous, je suis d'accord avec vous, but she went with, vous avez absolument raison, perfect.
Ce sont des petits films, pas les films avec un grand budget, avec distribution énorme.
And the first thing I like about this clip is she says, ce sont des petits films. Ce sont des petits films. In everyday French, ce sont is used so much more rarely than c'est, even when it's a plural thing that you're talking about. Here she's talking about multiple films, des petits films. Ce sont des petits films. In everyday French, you hear people say, c'est des petits films. C'est des petits films, and there wouldn't be anyone complaining about your French. But here she uses the perfect French, says ce sont des petits films. So that's the first thing I want to comment on this clip. And the second thing is she either doesn't know or she doubts the fact that budget is actually a French word as well. I don't think it's an anglicism. I don't think it's an English word brought into the French language, at least Word Reference doesn't indicate so. She says budget and then keeps on with the rest of the French in French pronunciation. But actually, the word budget is French as well. So budget, you don't pronounce the T in typical French fashion, but it's budget, avec un petit budget, I think she says. But there is something about that word, perhaps the way it's spelled, it just doesn't look French. So I tend to look at it and think that's an English word they've stolen.
Ce sont des petits films, pas les films avec un grand budget, avec distribution énorme. Et ce sont des petits films d'art. Et pour possible la seule fois dans la vie de ce film, c'est montré dans une grande salle avec un son incroyable.
Now you know by now, if you've been watching my videos for a while, that the most important thing in any French conversation is to get your point across, not have the most perfect words, just get your point across. And if you want help with that, you can get your hands on a copy of my guide and workbook linked down below. But what I like about her here is she goes to a next level and she uses something which is particularly French native, at least in my opinion. It's not something translated from English, which would get your point across. She goes to the next level and it shows her comfort with the language. She says, dans une salle avec un son incroyable. She's talking about a cinema theater. She says, dans une salle avec un son incroyable. And this, in my opinion, is a native French thing to say because she says un son incroyable, a room with an incredible sound. In English, it's subtle, but we wouldn't say an incredible sound, a room with great sound, with great acoustics, something like that. So we make it plural, but in French, it's un son incroyable. And it just shows her extra comfort with that. We can't do this video without mentioning that Helen Mirren said, oh la la.
Oh là là.
But no, classic French expression.
Quel est le premier film que vous avez vu
dans ma vie?
Oui.
Oh là là. Je crois que c'était un film de Bolshoi Ballet.
The main point I want to bring up in this clip is that she says je crois que. Je crois que, which is perfectly said, lovely pronunciation, but grammatically speaking, it is really perfect. And I bring this up because us English speakers, myself and yourself, particularly if you're a native English speaker, we have trouble remembering to say the que in sentences like je crois que or je pense que. You see, in English, the equivalent of que is that. And if I say I think that I'm good at French, I don't have to say the that, I can say I think I'm good at French. So that means in our heads, when we start speaking French, we cut that out because us humans, we like efficiency. We like to say something in the shortest way possible. But in French, the que is mandatory, you have to say it. So I love that she kept it in here. Je crois que, je crois que.
Quand j'étais jeune, je vivais avec ma famille dans une cité qui n'avait pas beaucoup de cinéma. Alors, les films qui viennent étaient 2, 3, 4, 5 jours,
années après la sortie.
First good thing here is she says, je vivais dans une cité. Je vivais dans une cité. She's talking about when she was young. When you're talking about stuff in the past that was recurring, or you're describing something in the past, you use the imparfait, you don't use the passé composé. I know it's something really tricky for us learners. So she says, je vivais, perfect. Imparfait form of vivre. Je vivais dans une cité. Now here, I think she's incorrectly using the word cité. She's translating from city in English to cité. I may be wrong about this, but in today's France, une cité is typically either used to talk about a ancient or medieval city, like la cité de Carcassonne in the south of France, beautiful. Or it's also used to talk about what Word Reference describes as une banlieue défavorisée. Une banlieue défavorisée, which basically means a poor neighborhood, a poor suburb. It's often people who are living with very low means. So I don't know, that was perhaps her case, and if so, well done, she's using a very accurate word. But I think she means ville, dans une ville.
Quand j'étais jeune, je vivais avec ma famille dans une cité qui n'avait pas beaucoup de cinéma. Alors, les films qui viennent étaient 2, 3, 4, 5 jours,
années après
la sortie. Okay.
Oui, bravo Helen, you speak lovely French, I love it. Je vais vous donner une note de 15 sur 20. But what do you think? Let me know down in the comments below. Don't hesitate to let me know in the comments who you would like me to review next. And also don't forget that you can get a copy of my workbook and guidebook for French learners wanting to speak more confidently down in the description below. You can watch more videos of me breaking down and reviewing the French of English speaking celebrities by clicking one of the things on screen right now. But until next time everyone, merci beaucoup de m'avoir rejoint aujourd'hui. À la prochaine. Ciao.